We see signs all the time, and some of us obey and prepare for the signs because it gives us direction. So when you don't obey or prepare for the signs, you can't get mad at nobody but yourself when you have to face the consequences. Every day, we listen to the weather and prepare for whatever condition the weather may bring. But you know, when it comes to paying attention to the signs of Jesus' return, many of us don't give these signs a second thought, as if there would not be any consequences. And so many don't prepare for Jesus' second coming just because they don't see metal signs lodged in the cement in the streets of Jesus' return. It doesn't mean the signs of him returning aren't there. Matthew chapter 24 describes the signs of Jesus' return, and these signs were written over 1,953 years ago in 70 AD that we see now coming into fruition. Matthew 24 verse 4 says, Jesus told his disciples, "Don't let anyone fool you, for many will come claiming to be the Messiah and will lead many astray." And we see this happening today. Jesus also said in 24:6, "You will hear of wars beginning. Nations and kingdoms of the earth will rise against each other, famine and earthquakes in many places." And you see that all around us today. You hear all the time about the earthquakes. We hear about famine. We see on TV how people say give to the people in Africa and other places because of famine in the land. But all of this will be only the beginning of the horrors to come. Then, Scripture tells us, you will be tortured and killed and hated all over the world because you are mine, says Jesus. And we see this hate and torture today as followers of Jesus Christ. But listen to this. Jesus says, and many of you shall fall back into sin. Many of you will fall back into sin and betray and hate each other, and many false prophets will appear and lead many astray. Listen. For those hearers and believers of Jesus' words, this was written thousands of years ago, and it holds true today, to this very day. For the unbeliever, this is your proof text. Jesus said, the good news about the kingdom will be preached throughout the whole world, so that all, Jesus said, all nations will hear it. And then finally, the end will come. And then at last, the signal of Jesus' coming will appear in the heavens, and there will be deep mourning all around the earth. And the nations of the world will see Jesus arrive in the clouds, nowhere else, but in the clouds with power and great glory. Just so when you see all these things beginning to happen, you can know that Jesus' return is near, even at the doors. Then at last, this age right here, will come to its close. Look, just as in the days of Noah, people were secure and careless. They knew not until the flood came. And once again, in this day and age. People will be secure and careless. They'll be secure in the stock market. They'll be secure in their treasures up here on earth. And they'll be careless and know not until Jesus' second coming. Matthew Henry commentary described it this way. What words can more strongly describe the suddenness of our Savior's coming? Men will be at their respective businesses, and suddenly the Lord of glory will appear. Women will be in their house employments, but in that moment, every other work will be laid aside, and every heart will turn inward and say, "It is the Lord." Am I prepared to meet him? Can I stand before him? But guess what? Jesus said, but those enduring to the end shall be saved. Matthew 25 goes on to say, it talks about the 10 virgins. But we don't want to be like the parable of the five bridesmaids being foolish and forgot to put oil in their lamps. And every heart will turn inward and say, "It is the Lord." And those foolish ones that forgot and didn't prepare, shame on you. People, we have got to prepare. Get ready, because Jesus is coming back soon. Now, I don't own the rights to the music or the graphics, but I thank God for them. I am Minister Sharon Ford of Spiritual Care of Southfield. May our Lord and Savior be with you until we meet again. The time is now to repent. We are so thankful and grateful for Jesus. We thank him for dying on the cross for our sins, as we give him all the praise, honor, and glory in the name of Jesus. This I pray. Amen. Question is, when will Jesus return? I want you to know. Soon.